Now it is time for picks and bans for game number one, KT Rolster versus Spenu Sonic Boom. And Maokai, the first ban, is trying to take, I would say, just safe picks away from Spenu. And, you know, I feel like you don't really need to do a lot of target banning versus Spenu. You just sort of take all-around solid picks away. What do you think?
Yeah, I think you should take some of these easier-to-play champions, yeah, especially since Sol can go onto Kennen or Aurelia, which, you know, if you're KT, it's pretty easy to shut down those champions if their individual players are not up to par. They're going to ban the Ryze against someday after the Maokai. So two top lane bans really so far, and there is Kalista not going to be picked up by Arrow. You have to believe that the first pick Sivir will come in here for KT.
Well, undoubtedly, that's what they're going to be trying to go for as usual. I'd love to see something like a first pick Echo or something like that, but it's going to be the Sivir. There's a Hecarim ban against Sunday.
Yeah, I'd love to see Echo as well. I mean, we did see Spenu play it already earlier this week.
Wasn't that great, though? We actually haven't really seen the best Echo.
Actually,
play.
I thought Coco did pretty well.
You think so?
Yeah, his team was just... CJ fell apart because Ambition and Shy could not find the proper flanks. It wasn't anything to do with Coco's individual play.
I thought he had a good early game, but it seemed like he looked very lost in the late game. You're saying that's just because they were behind enough that he couldn't really participate anyway?
No, I'm saying that CJ completely botched their team fight engages. So it wasn't that he was too far behind. He was actually ahead.
All right. Well, Echo ban against Spenu. And there's Yanni ban. Okay. Yanni ban against Fixer. All right. Well, he has been pretty good on that champion. So will it be the Sivir first pick again for KT? Alistar, priority
Alistar,
as well.
They're going
to grab it. Now, will Spenu take away the Sivir? Grog is still up too, which is a champion that catches played quite a bit of.
Wow, they're actually going to take Corki away right here. That is a bit interesting to grab this early on in the draft when you know that this Sivir priority exists. I mean, if you just look at KT's wins, it's just like Sivir, 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 Sivir.
It's very bizarre.
Okay, it's going to be Rek'Sai Sivir again. This is giving a lot of power picks over to KT. Now, we've seen Victor before from KT, of course from Nagne, but we'll have to check out how Edge does on the champion. Now, this is going to be a very strong engage composition already, and they have, well, they can kite very easily too with this Victor. We'll see which direction they go in terms of their top laner and their jungle.
True enough. A couple picks over to Spenu Sonic Boom. And what do you go with to try to punish this Victor Sivir? It's kind of hard to punish a Victor Sivir, honestly.
It's one of the most powerful champion combinations, I think, in the game right now. You have good engage, you have good kiting for the Victor. Victor gets, you know, his weaknesses in terms of his low mobility are really covered up by a Sivir, as long as you have enough peel for him. And even if you get assassins to try and punish him, he could just kite you out with his Q, his upgraded Q, and the Sivir speed boost in the late game. So Janna is going to be the lock-in here. Bit interesting. Rumble Janna not going for an engage support in this situation. Wonder what their mid lane pick is going to be. It's probably going to be something without a lot of mobility that needs peel if they're going to go for the Janna.
Now, how much kiting can you get out of this Spenu composition? Because if you think about, you know, pushing KT away when they try to engage with the Sivir ultimate, you know, can you really kite effectively between the Corki rockets, Equalizer, stuff like that?
Sure. I really think it's going to depend on what their mid lane pick is to see how this composition comes together in the end. And they could go for the Rengar. They have the Sivir. It would be strong backline engage, but this Rengar is just going to kind of get bounced out of the fight.
Should be.
By a Gragas or a Janna. And the Rek'Sai, I think, is a much safer overall pick. And there is Sunday's Riven coming
all
in
right
again.
Yeah, we've seen it a few times. And will it actually be this Diana for Spenu? Jumped on it pretty quickly. And I wonder how Diana would do against Victor. You know, with the Q, with the ultimate, you could perhaps get around his gravity field fairly efficiently. But still, I mean, once you're there, what are you going to do?
Well, the problem with Diana is once you go in, he's going to drop the gravity field on his feet
on himself,
and then
yeah,
stun you. So I don't really think that's going to be very helpful. If we want to talk about champions that we've seen be successful against Victor, we want to start looking at champions like Ahri or Zed.
Right. Well, the Vel'Koz has been hovered over quite a bit by Spenu Sonic Boom this season, but I don't think we're going to see them pick it. Q lock in. Oh, well, they're letting it count down.
The mid Vel'Koz, the secret Victor counter. No, it's Jace.
Oh, okay. Jace fills similar functions to Vel'Koz, but just does much better.
So that explains the Janna pick now, that we have the Jace. They've got good peel. They've got great peel for their poke build, good mix of AD and AP damage. And they also have the Gragas to isolate targets. And, you know, Jason Hammer Stance, if you can get him in a 1v1 situation, actually does an obscene amount of damage. So he can really burst somebody down in melee form pretty quickly. So I have to say, I like this composition quite a bit from Spenu. It is going to be focused on a power spike in the mid game once the Tier and the Trinity Force get rolling, as well with Rumble. But powerful combination. KT has some really good engage options, though. They're going to be relying on that Sivir ult and Alistair, but with the poke damage from Victor's Death Ray, someday could have some options in terms of just executing people later on. And his split push is not going to be easy to stop as well.
Yeah, so can Spenu, you know, maybe get an advantage early on and then translate that into poke, into kite that keeps KT away? Is that kind of what we're looking at here? Is Spenu really needing to take the edge early?
Yeah, they got to get some turrets down very quickly in this game.
Seems that way.
And otherwise, no one's going to be able to deal with the Riven late is going to be the primary issue.
Unfortunately for them, KT already has the edge this game.
Oh no,
make it stop quick. It's time to get in the game, guys. KT versus Spenu, game one. It's go time. How many edge jokes can we make? The answer is, I will try to not make any more. Welcome to Summoner's Rift. Once again, guys, KT Rolster versus Spenu Sonic Boom. You know, they've got Charlie Nash coming back in Street Fighter V. He also throws out the Sonic Boom.
Wow, I was really excited for that.
I know, right?
I haven't seen anything about Street Fighter V yet.
It looks really cool, man.
I know nothing about fighting games.
Used to be all I played, dude. Back in the day, just Street Fighter, the Primal Rage, Killer Instinct.
That was way
Mortal
back
Kombat.
In the day.
Well, Primal Rage specifically, yeah. I've kept up with Street Fighter, and that's about it. That's really the only fighting game I play now. I'm a dirty Zangief main. But I don't just mindlessly rotate the stick. I'm very thoughtful and very cerebral about my Zangief playing.
That doesn't sound like you at all.
Hey, you haven't seen me play Hearthstone, man. What are you talking about? Support is very cerebral. You got to think to get those bloodthirsty kills, man. You can't just run into people and press R like all the other champions.
You have to calculate precisely when you're going to kill steal with your Glitter Lance.
That's right. And we know math is my strong point, so so I'm really good at it.
Well, someday overall, interestingly on this Riven, is 4-2 lifetime.
Pretty
and
good.
He's played it in a lot of situations, and he just seems to randomly pull it out, regardless of what the meta is. Now I'm sure, sees Smeb and is starting to get a little bit jealous here of the Riven success. Remember, he played it in one game in the finals of Champions Summer last year against Samsung Blue. He lost with it, but it's still something that he feels confident in. He does play it a lot in solo queue, and he always has.
Hmm. Seems like it could be. I mean, we know Smeb's really good with it. We know Someday's good with it. Do you think this Riven could actually start to become a little bit more common of a pick? And that wolf is going to kill Soul. Goodbye. Wow. Dead to the wolves. Well, it's a great start for Samsung.
Well,
or not Samsung. Spenu Sonic Boom already.
He joined the Dyrus Club. Dying to wolves.
Oh, I feel bad, man. He looks really sad about that. Now I feel
kind of
bad.
Well, he is massively screwed, Noah.
Yep.
The reason why is not because that death really has any impact. He didn't hit level 2 off those camps, and now Someday hit level 2 and is in lane with him and is playing Riven, a champion that is going to wreck his face if he falls behind. And the other scary thing here is that if I was playing a game of League of Legends and Champions, if I had to pick one top laner I really didn't want to fall behind against, it's Someday. Because his level of punishment when he gets an advantage is tops in this league. He is able to do more with the lead and hold the other top laner down for longer than just about anybody else. So this is a pretty big issue.
Oh, man. And Skor could just totally camp this lane, too. I mean, well, Soul with that teleport.
What are they going to do? I mean, they nose catch is there right now. Score still coming in for the mid lane gank, and they're just going to go for it.
Wow, yeah, trying to force at least a summoner out of sauce, and that doesn't work. In fact, Score taking a lot of damage. Oops. Oh, well.
Sossen pulling back right there, and the tunnel just going a bit too far.
Yeah.
But they didn't really commit anything at all to that, so well, not the biggest deal in the world.
You would think just diving soul would be the priority now for KT. Just kind of continuing to try to punish, and we already see Someday putting down a pretty deep ward in the enemy jungle. Do you think this is setting up for some early action?
I think that they just really want to abuse Someday's advantage in the top lane, and so they're going to ward the top side. Score is going to repeatedly invade up there and just make it so Someday can constantly push this rumble underneath the tower and then just gauge their dive based on that. It's a really smart strategy to use in this situation. You know, the Riven pick is very interesting to me because she could do obviously very well in lane. And considering how much burst damage we have going on these days, or at least poke damage, we see the Corki and the Ku Tigers, the way they like to run that Riven is they take a poke comp and then they just use the Riven to clean up fights with that big execute on the Windslash. So I think Riven is pretty decent these days, especially when the poke comes in and then Riven flanks you with a teleport. It is nasty stuff. And we saw Smeb with a pentakill on that Riven, our first ever top lane pentakill.
Yeah, look pretty strong doing it. Score thinking about trying to come in again. We'll see if Sossen pushes forward here. I think he's going to play it pretty cautiously, though.
I'm still waiting for the support pentakill, Doa.
Yeah, someday. Someday it'll happen.
So we haven't had jungle or support pentakills yet. Just AD carry and mid pretty much every time except for one lonely Smeb Riven pentakill now.
Well, it's the way the damage usually ends up working.
It's just fun to see what a diverse meta we have right now for top lane coming in around the world these days. We've seen that Echo coming into the top lane, so we have so many picks that can be used. We've got mages, we've got tanks, we've got bruisers, got assassins. It's a really, really good meta, and it also means that as a team, you have to have a very good top laner these days. Otherwise, your strategy is going to be pretty one-dimensional.
Yeah. Well, they see Ketch coming into the jungle here, but Ketch also gets a ward down to spot Score. Going to see him head down to mid. Meanwhile, Sossen getting a little bit of time to farm up as Edge went back. Looks like upgraded is Hex Core. Oh, Headbutt Pulverize. A lot of damage on the Nuclear here. Shield from Spirit helping a lot, though. Arrow is not going anywhere, though. Getting a lot of good autos in.
Yep, Arrow just walking forward on the Nuclear. There's a Boomerang Blade. I mean, Arrow's been very good on the Sivirin. You know, KT got a lot of very good power picks in this composition. And the scary thing is that if they can free up Fixer from lane, the tower dive is going to be pretty terrifying to deal with the Riven and Alistar together against this Rumble, even if that Equalizer is available. Which it is, and it was just used to clear out the wave.
Okay. So not a lot to worry about for KT in the near future as far as what Soul can bring to a team fight. Goes with the Magic Pen boots first, too.
I don't know about that. Let's see how Someday responds to it. He's just going to push the wave up and go back while Soul walks into lane. Edge holding his own so far. Sasa not getting too much of a CS advantage, but it's just mostly been that farm fest, of course.
Yeah. Not a lot of action paid to the mid lane just because of the weird situation up in top bot. But as I say that, Ketch coming in. No
time
wards.
For Camp the Rookie?
I think so.
Every team's favorite strategy, of course, but Score's there. He's got the Tremor Sense, so he knows exactly what's going on. And
he's playing Protect the Rookie this game. He knows how this Camp the Rookie game works.
Well, you know, Rookie went to IG, so he can't protect the Rookie as well as he used to be able to.
It's true. He's on his own now. Has to spread his Rookie wings and fly in China, I guess.
So Someday comes back with the Hex Drinker.
Reasonable.
Very reasonable choice. Couple wards as well. See how deep he wants to go with them or what their plan is. That's pretty just calm early game here. By the way, guys, we are still on 5.10, so those Jace buffs have not come through yet.
Right.
But we've seen Jace in Korea, especially Coco, pulling out the pick from time to time. So it's definitely not a common pick, if you don't watch that much Korean League of Legends, but a viable pocket pick, I would say, for certain players. Mm. And one thing, I would say the other bright spot on Sossin, besides Nuclear's play occasionally, or on Spenu, has been Sossin's champion pool. He's actually played a lot of different champions this season.
Both Sossin and Nuclear, yeah, have been somewhat of a bright spot in Spenu in that they're willing to sort of be diverse as far as their picks go. It's a good start anyway. I think this is like Sossin's ninth champion this season or something like that.
He's played a lot of different champions. He's played Assassins, he's played Lulu.
Yeah.
Now we're seeing him play with Poke champion. Their draft looks good this game, and you know, it really hasn't been Spenu's draft that's been the issue. It's been their method of execution and their individual abilities. They just can't make the big plays on their own, and they can't really work as a team. So with that, you have not very good League of Legends resulting.
Yeah. Man, look at the top lane lead that Someday has acquired in CS. 82-49 right now, just really, really punishing this Rumble hard.
Well,
and when you start with the Magic Pen boots too, you have like no extra health. You have no real presence in lane. Starting with the boots is kind of weird.
I mean, this would be a hard lane if they were even, but the fact that he died to the wolves makes it absolutely unbearable for this Rumble.
Yeah.
And there's just this constant threat of Someday going to be getting a gank and then taking him out in that top side. And Score has done a very good job of repeatedly getting wards so that Someday knows that he's perfectly safe to keep pushing. There we go.
There's a flash knock up onto Sossin. Sossin flashing away as well. Can Edge get him? Not quite. Looks like the Ignite. Chaos Storm, not enough. I guess there was no Ignite there, but the Chaos Storm, not quite enough damage to finish him off. Has to go back, though. Catch coming to take over the lane while Sossin goes back and buys. Edge might have to do that, too.
I don't know why Edge has Exhaust.
Huh.
Because he's playing against a Poke comp right here. I guess he's worried about a Jace all-in in Hammer Stance. It's the only thing I can think of.
Could be.
But, I mean, I'm not very familiar with this matchup, so maybe that is a factor that I'm unaware of in the matchup, is that the way Jace wins, because Victor can't escape, is just to use To the Skies on him and start hitting him in Hammer Stance after like landing a Shock Blast and chunking him out or something like that. But you would think that Ignite would be a more powerful option here.
Well, I've seen a lot of Victors go with that Ignite. You know, Faker was the first one, but if it's not Ignite, it's usually Cleanse. This time Exhaust, interesting. So Edge maybe just kind of playing it extra safe against this Jace. A little bit overly safe, but it's his first game ever. You know, he wants to be very comfortable in lane.
Yeah. And it'll be hard for him to use the Ignite in the late game anyway, because no one's really going to be close enough to him with how much poke and how much range they have.
Yeah.
So, at least in an ideal situation, and at least in the late game, if they do happen to get close to him, he will have that Exhaust to use. Maybe on Rumble as well, in the front
line. Sure enough. Sossin's taken a lot of damage to his turret so far, already at about half health. Nuclear and Secret holding on pretty well in the bot lane. And Someday really gunning for that flame prize. And here we go, Score. Fun curling in. There's a knockup and Sossin. Oh, man. Thank you, Raptors. Edge gets the first blood. Sossin just decides to the skies, the Raptors.
Oh, wow.
Whoa,
Edge
nice
getting knocked
barrel.
Into the turret right there. He's going to have to run away.
Yeah, puts a gravity field on himself to try to stay safe. Here we go. Exhaust on to Catch as Score comes back over the wall. Catch trying to stay alive. Edge coming in to try to finish him off. Can't quite get it, though. Fixer was there, too. It's a good play by Catch, but Edge just had too much support.
Yeah, and that Riot, or that Victor, once you put the gravity field under your feet, you're able to do a lot right there, and he got out of the range of Catch by using the Q also. Already has that upgraded on his Hex Core, so.
Uh-oh, it's time for dive. Soul getting knocked out from under his turret. There's a Pulverize as well. Fixer taking a lot of turret damage. Equalizer goes down, does quite a bit of damage to Someday, but not quite enough. As Fixer with his ultimate is able to tank his way through those turret hits, and an easy dive for KT and a kill for Someday.
Well, that's exactly what I thought would happen once Fixer hit 6. Just go into that top side, start abusing that lead. 40 CS, the advantage for Someday already as he cleans up the rest of this wave right here. And now Soul's in a really difficult position. Does he actually TP to the top side? He's going to lose even more experience. He's still a level down. Or is he just going to walk to the top, lose that CS, and then someday maybe gets a play onto this Dragon? Fixers here clearing out Ward's catch. Really wants this red buff. They have to get something, but that is going to be found out.
Know. Yeah, Headbutt Pulverize gets smited. Catch, I think he was able to actually grab that. Yeah, he did. Okay, so they did take the red buff. So mission accomplished there. Now, what if, you know, Spenu wanted to just lane swap? Is it too late for that? Do they give up too much dragon control?
They would definitely give up the dragon in that case. They have to focus on this power spike that's coming up for them. They're not too far behind in gold yet. And especially because the Rumble, it's not going to matter too terribly much that he doesn't have that many items at this point in time. Sol actually had to get home guards just because he's been pushed back out of lane so much, and he needs to have that teleport up to make it 5v5, where the risk is they fight a dragon at a 5v4. Catch doing his best just to solo the dragon right now, score on top. They should have some suspicion that this is going on.
He's going to try. It looks like Sossin's going to come down and help a little bit. Oh, one shock blast. That's all you get. Okay, never mind. Seeker coming up to help as well, too. There's the ward. So they do know it's up, but it's a little bit too late. And Spenu manages to grab the first dragon for themselves.
Very sloppy control there, actually, from KT. But Spenu manages to sneak that dragon in. Sunday just not going to teleport into that. No really good teleport ward. And because Score was taking their red buff right there, they just couldn't have any control. And his Void Rush was down, so there wasn't really much they could do.
I suppose not the biggest concern for KT. No. That Spenu got that first dragon. Look, they're going to get the top turret. So,
I mean,
still
Rumble,
having that nice gold lead either way.
Rumble has gotten 5 CS in the span of time it took Someday to get 20 more.
That's crazy.
So he's been farming ever since that last recall at 1/4 rate. It is an unmitigated disaster what happened in this top lane in this game. And I mean, Someday's going to be a monster. And it's even more problematic because now that the Tiamat's done, who can stop Someday split pushing? No one. No one can stop it.
They need to commit a lot of people to do that. And when they commit, they're going to lose more turrets. Another lanes. Meanwhile, that mid turret almost down. Edge managing to poke that. And, you know, perhaps a soft opponent in Sossin. But Edge still untested as well and doing pretty admirably in this 1v1. Meanwhile, action down to bot lane. Secret getting very low, but with that whirlwind, he should be able to escape, and he will.
Yep. Catch just wandering down to that side of the map as well. Score, I got some wards in the river, but that's about it. It's just all about powering up Someday right now and snowballing the victory that they've already accrued in the top lane. Sol's going to show those wolves his boss this time around.
You know, it's almost looking like Someday is going to be able to hit the flame horizon while still in laning phase. That's a bit insane.
It's not... not good.
No. not good for Sol. Wow.
I can't wait to see Someday start getting into team fights with this lead that he has right now.
I know.
It's going to be ridiculous. I mean, nobody on this team even has armor. Someday's going to slaughter everyone.
Well, imagine just like the AoE between Sivir, Viktor, and Riven. It is going to be disgusting, guys.
All Someday needs to do is like hop into the middle with Broken Wings and hit his Tiamat once, and then press R, and then the entire team will die.
Yeah. Basically. There goes the bottom turret, too. So just within the span of a minute or two, KT able to take down all three outer turrets. That gold lead already 5K at 17 minutes. Yeah. You used the term unmitigated disaster earlier. I think it's applying all team-wide at this point. It's not just the top lane.
Yeah, this is red alert for Spenu, Sonic Boom at this stage. We're only 17 minutes in. And remember, there are only 2 kills. But KT is 5,000 gold ahead. Oh, goodbye, Sol.
Yeah, Sol in a lot of trouble. Someday manages to find him. There's the stun. Sol still in a lot of trouble. No flash. And there it goes. An easy 1v1 for Someday. That wasn't even really a 1v1. That was like just a one person killing somebody trying to run away. There was no versus part of that fight.
And this is how Someday plays. You know, he... when he goes even, sometimes he has some problems. When he falls behind, he sometimes has some problems. But man, if you get this guy ahead, he just takes over the map. I mean, his level of domination of this game, basically nobody can go into the topside jungle at this stage. They've got the wards down. He's working really well with Score, and he's taking every single camp, and he's killing you if you walk anywhere close to him. So this is why I say that Someday is the last person I would want to die to wolves to first, because that level advantage has been just snowballed out of control before 20 minutes.
Oh, score's going to jump on catch here, do a little bit of damage to him. That's got to hurt so bad to die to wolves like that as well. I mean, geez, how does that happen?
Well, I mean, we've actually seen it very close a couple times now when players play Rumble because they really want to get that level 2 and use the TP before going into lane.
I mean, to be fair, oh, here we go. Headbutt, Pulverize, score, and Fixer trying to mix it up a little bit in the jungle. Here comes Arrow. Arrow pops his ultimate, Soul coming down to try to provide some moral support. There's a kill on the catch already. Someday exhausted, but he manages to get the ult off and take out Secret. And meanwhile, more action. Wow. Nuclear just disappearing, man.
I'm pretty sure the only damage Someday is taking right now is from turrets as he dives them.
Probably.
Very clean series of events right there. Someday just going to smash this turret to smithereens with the health of Arrow. And they back off afterwards after picking up even more kills. Someday has a Hydra and cooldown boots. He's...
Hail Hydra.
He's two levels up now on the enemy top laner. He's rapidly approaching that Flame Horizon. There we go. Nice engage from Fixer. And
yeah.
Svenu can't fight this. They have an ulting Alistar in the middle of them right there. They can't do any damage, and it's just easy cleanup from Someday. Secret gets the exhaust down, but Someday just waits for it to fade before finishing him off with the ult. And now here we go. Nuclear under the turret, but a very quick headbutt pulv combo from Fixer. And they kill him and the tower as well. Four turrets to none. And if it wasn't for that single dragon that they got earlier, we would be looking at the possibility of a perfect game from KT Rolster.
Yep, doesn't look like Spenu's going to get much more this game. Just the sheer amount of burst coming out of KT right now. This takes down people so fast.
Yeah, it's terrifying. And the thing is, Spenu is now 8K down. They're never going to be able to hit the power spike that they need in order to siege effectively. And they have to be scared out of their minds with so few turrets. In order to siege, they have to push up away from safe territory from the turrets for so far that KT's going to have a really easy time getting behind them.
Soul flashing back Someday, not really even taking much damage off of that turret, able to heal up off the minions too.
Okay.
Used his ult, so that's going to be down for a little bit, but it's not going to save the turret.
Well, he's on the run still. There's some turret damage. Equalizer goes down. He's going to try and use his R. He doesn't need it to kill Soul, though, and he knows it.
I don't think so.
Janna's here too, just to try and save Soul as they run around in the jungle. But that's, again, doesn't matter. Someday's denying CS while he does this. They're just melting into the turret at the moment.
I think KT kind of playing around at this point too, you know?
Oh no,
I think so far ahead.
I think Someday should absolutely just be in everyone's face right now doing this kind of stuff because he's so far.
Yep, he's certainly in their face right now. No ult, no needed. Fixer getting a little bit low. Backs away. Chaos Storm doing a big chunk of damage to Sossin. Fixer managed to make it out of that.
The poke from Edge is doing a ton of work at the moment as well. They're just going to transition this straight into a dragon while Fixer goes home to get some HP. But Someday has that lifesteal on the objective. He's going to be able, he's nearly got his ultimate back up again.
Yep, well, dragon. Whoa, yeah, Nuclear managed to steal it with the big one. Nice rocket from Nuclear. So that's two dragons now for Spenu.
I mean, Score didn't have Smite there.
Yeah, a bit of a cocky dragon from KT. LOL.
That was...
It's a bit embarrassing.
That was embarrassing. Someday still going in, though. Okay. Oh,
now the anger begins. And, oh, Someday not quite able to hit the range on that ultimate because of the whirlwind. They're still going to be able to push these turrets fairly easily.
Going for more cooldown reduction right now as well. Someday, that Kindle Gem. See what he's going to do with it. Could be a Spirit Visage.
Could be.
Well, they can pretty much take the Baron whenever they want right now. KT with so much damage on their team that they can melt the Baron very fast.
Yeah. KT, though, the type of team, I suppose, to close things out kind of methodically. A little bit on the slower side.
They do like to dive turrets, though. That is definitely within their character, so.
They do, but when it comes to, like, really pushing big lane advantages and things like that, I feel like we don't see them do that as often.
They like to kill people.
Yeah,
what they like
exactly.
To do. KT wins usually have quite a few kills in them. And looks like they're going to keep up that trend. Again, nobody being able to stop the Riven means that she's going to be able to push up in this bottom side and meet a challenger directly at that turret in the bottom lane. Problem for Sol is he's so far away from getting a Zhonya's Hourglass that it's not really going to be in the cards for him to even deal with this Riven remotely for probably the rest of this game,
yeah.
Given the gold lead. But if we also take a look at, I mean, it's just, man, the level advantage is now up to 3 for Someday. It's so crazy to think about how Spenu has to deal with this. Riven is 2 levels higher than anybody on their team.
For that fast level 18, looks like they're going to get the tier 2 turret up in top lane, while Edge just zones a bit, putting down that gravity shield or field. There goes the turret. 5 turrets to 0 so far. And Spenu not really able to mount much of a damage throwback there.
Well, what are they going to do? It's too much. I mean, look at that. There's 4,100 gold at 24 minutes into this game that Someday has over Sol. He passed the Flame Horizon at about 21 minutes.
Yeah.
The level of this destruction out of Someday is just incredible.
It would mean that Someday, too, has about half of the lead that KT has over Spenu right now, too.
Yes. Yeah, just by himself. That's what is so dangerous about him. KT, not only Someday, but his team knows how to play around the fact that he's ahead, as we saw from Score multiple times in this game. Very smart, intelligent jungling coming out of KT's jungler. And now they're wrapping around this turret. There's a flash, actually.
Yeah, they're going to try to make a play here. Edge push out, but he gets right back to safety. Here we go. Fixer coming from the side, and that is a nice set of CC to get KT a couple kills on the run now. Fixer's still taking turret damage, but it will go down. So it was a nice attempt by Catch, but Fixer, or Edge rather, was ready to get out. Fixer and Someday coming in with the plays.
Well, they had to do something, right? They don't have a Baron yet, so this is probably their best chance to face KT. Catch thought he could actually find Edge there with a flash explosive cast, but in the end, Edge, quick fingers, gets out of there before he can get the CC chain going on. And with Someday already behind the turret, he's there to clean things up. 4-0-0 this game.
Yeah.
And they see him in that brush, so he's going to have to take a hike. Put down a ward first, though.
He will take a leisurely stroll, you know? Not really needing the hike, per se. It doesn't hike involves some sort of, like, arduous walk, right?
It's true. He's just got teleport. He doesn't have to walk at all. He's just a lazy, lazy bum.
Yeah. This looks more like a stroll. Look at that. It's very casual. He's like, ooh, skipping for joy. I bet Riven would do very well in the hop, skip, jump event. You ever do that back at track meets in, like, grade school or something?
No.
They called it the triple jump because hop, skip, jump doesn't sound cool enough. You know, I have for a long time, I don't know if I still did, I had the standing long jump record at my middle school. So there's my claim to fame. How about that?
He says, well, famously on broadcast.
Yes.
I'm right. Glad that's what you hold nearest and dearest to your heart out of your accomplishments.
I'm proud of that, man. I can't remember how far it was, but it was far.
You were just one step away from the Olympics, I'm sure.
That's right. When they put that event in the Olympics, I will be there. Standing in place and then jumping forwards. That's pretty sick. Yep. I remember people tried to break it. They couldn't do it. Just like Spenny was going to try to break KT. They've got about as much chance as anyone trying to break my standing long jump record.
So what was your middle school, in case there's any? Oh, okay.
It was huge. Oh, Score coming in. Gets the knockup. And there's a nice headbutt pulverize. Oh, man. Someday comes right over the top. Janna tries to separate everybody but dies before she really gets much from the ultimate. So only 2 kills coming out of that. KT having to back away, but without Secret's ult, that would have been an absolute slaughter.
Well, and the very critical exhaust onto Someday there from Secret as soon as he got into the mix, because that was just a massive flash Riven play to lock everyone up, and he got everywhere right in the middle of that composition for another couple of assists on that play.
Yeah. Man, Secret prevented that from being an ace, actually.
Oh, of course, Black Cleaver coming in. How silly of me.
Yeah.
Of course, that's naturally going to be the item right there. I thought he might go for a little bit more defense, considering how far ahead he is, but he's just going to go full offense right here. Someday, trying to deny the poke on this Baron, and that's going to do it. Score secures it with the smite.
Yep. See, when's the Zerat's portal coming in for Someday? He needs a little bit of tankiness, I think, you know?
The Manor portal.
That's right.
Where is his Ulm Wrecker so he can dive them with zero? Because that's the only thing that's been dealing damage to him.
Exactly. Turn off the turrets. Well, I mean, ignore those Corki rockets. That was just long-range turret, guys. He needs the Ulm Wrecker, though. I agree completely.
More Ulm Wrecker.
Yep. I like the concept behind Ulm Wrecker, but the problem is that it seems like you really can't give it great stats, otherwise it's just going to become, like, way too good.
Yes.
So because it has bad stats, the ability suddenly doesn't become worth it. But if you want the ability to be worth it, you have to give it stats that make it good enough to then make it overpowered.
Yes.
So it's just an item that will never actually function.
I agree with you on that, though. I really do.
Oh, well. Nice try. It's a cool concept. I say just, they can't really turn into a champion ability. Well, they kind of did with Bard, I guess. But it doesn't directly target turrets, though.
Okay, well, here we go. Split push coming in. Of course, they have that Rek'Sai. They have the teleport on the Riven. So doing the 1-3-1 perfectly safe for them. But somebody's going to join the team right in the middle. And look how much damage he's doing.
Oh, yeah. That turret taking a lot. KT being careful about this, though. Not really wanting to overcommit too much.
No, they don't have to. They have so many options. They've got a wave pushing in the top side as well. And the poke here, they're being very wary of the fact that Spenu can kite this out. They may not want to dive it, especially with such little HP left on that mid lane turret.
Yep. And
there
we go. Yeah, coming into the ultimate now. Secret tries to push people away. Doesn't really do a whole lot. Equalizer hits pretty much nobody. Kill comes in for Arrow already. And KT's like, all right, now we'll take your turrets and your inhibitors. Someday it's just like, I'll zone, guys. Whoa, that was a lot of damage with the ult. Oh, man.
Basically, that means if Secret is at 50% HP, he will get executed by that ult.
He will die. That's true. He nearly did there. Yeah, it's looking pretty much like this one's going to end in the near future here. Baron buff nearly done now for KT, but they don't really need it. Wow, look at the damage from that Someday's taken from the turret. It's pretty significant. There we go. And meanwhile, in the bot lane, another inhibitor taken down. Someday's going to take the top one. And KT's total dismantling of Spenu is nearly complete now.
Exhaust onto Someday once again. Is he actually going to get the kill, though? No, can't quite reach it with the Wind Slash Secret. Close to dying, but not quite there.
Yeah, well, all three inhibitors out of the way. For KT, now all they need to do is just, I would say, one more back, get the health up, come back into lane, and just wreck people in the base, I guess.
Wow. Well, this has been impressive. Those two dragons, the only thing saving, and one of them was a rocket steal from Corki.
Yeah.
The only thing saving Spenu from getting perfect game here, zero towers, zero kills, and just total domination by KT Rolster. And you know, they have a good composition. They look like they may have gotten it together after their last couple of matches. This is definitely a return to the very clean style of play that we were seeing from them earlier in the season before they hit some road bumps against IM and Coup and then Anarchy, where especially the Anarchy game was so weird because in game two they had a spectacular advantage and managed to throw.
I mean, it's Spenu, too. I mean, KT, you'd have to expect anybody's really going to look pretty crisp against a team like Spenu Sonic Boom.
Well, except I am.
Well, I am. That's a whole different conversation right there. Oh, Someday comes in, decides to try to get a kill on to catch. Nearly does. He's in your base, killing your mans. There's the Equalizer going down. Everyone just sort of dancing around it a bit. Fades, and now the Nexus turret's under threat, of course. And KT, how shall they engage? There we go. Sivir ult used, going to just pick up the kill on the Nexus turret. Spenu's scared away by the sound of the ult. And the advancing KT team more than anything else. There goes the second Nexus turret. Someday gets pushed back, stays back. Not going to really worry about it too much as they can take out the Nexus. Fixer goes in for a bit of action and more kills. Easy peasy, and there goes the Nexus. So at 33 minutes, complete destruction. KT Rolster just destroys. Destroys in a way we do not see very often. Spinu Sonic Boom.
At the end of that game, Someday had over 14,000 gold.
Wow.
And Soul had about 7.5. So he nearly doubled the amount of gold in that one position that game. And yeah, sure, there were leads across the map, but Someday, holy cow, and it started off that death right at level one, but Someday took that lead and the advantage that you have with Riven as a strong laner and just turned it into that dismantling of Spenu Sonic Boom.
Poor Spenu, too. I mean, it started so off with, oh yeah. Well, it's time for picks and bans for game number two. With Spenu Sonic Boom versus KT Rolster, there's a Hecarim ban, so we will see if the Riven ban comes through. Do you think they are going to ban it? Do you think they identify Riven as the problem?
I don't think that was the problem. I think that Soul just falling so far behind early and Someday being Someday was the problem. We've seen Someday just dominate on a variety of champions.
Makes sense. Alistar banned against KT as well. Fixer had a pretty awesome game on that Alistar. A lot of good combos.
Interesting that Spenu doesn't want to first pick it right now. Maokai banned once again for KT.
I really wonder if this is setting Spenu up for first pick Sivir.
Yeah, I think you've got to go for that. Or Gragas is going to be the question.
Yeah.
But honestly, I would just ban Gragas right now if I was Spenu and try and take the Sivir away because that has just been such a comfort pick for KT. And we've seen what they look like without it. When they don't have that big ability to engage with the Sivir ult, they just aren't as good.
Annie.
Take away Annie.
Okay.
So they did last game as well.
So does KT perhaps want to ban that Gragas?
No. I think they just want to let him have the Gragas and then take the Rek'Sai and the Sivir.
Now, Echo is banned against Spenu last game. They're going to ban Kalista this time. So the Echo will be available.
Oh, I want to see Someday play Echo.
Yeah, that's the thing is I think KT is going to get the chance to get it. I would imagine Spenu's either going to grab that Gragas that we talked about or maybe the Sivir.
I think they will probably take the Gragas here. They did prioritize it when they got to them in the first round of the draft last time.
Yep, looks like they will.
And it's a very ambiguous pick. They could take away the Rek'Sai, but I don't really think that's going to help them that much. Now, Score, that's not true. Score did a lot of work with that Tremor Sense in the last game. We looked at this jungle pathing and the way that he was able to keep following Catch around and keep Someday safe, as well as getting those deep wards in. Score actually did do a lot of work to enable that snowball in top lane.
Now, Score's kind of defaulted over to Evelynn when Rek'Sai hasn't been available for a lot of his games, and I feel like a champion like that would just be a nightmare for Spenu with Rek'Sai Tremor Sense or not.
Well,
Gragas, okay.
It will be Gragas, and you're right. We've seen those Evelynn bans against KT also, and Score is just a player who he likes to play smart, and the less visible he could be on the map, he is sort of the invisible jungler. Not only when he plays Evelynn, but he's just not very confrontational on champions like Rek'Sai, and we saw that really come out in the last game. He just likes to slip in, get the wards down, and keep eyes on you, and then relay that information to his team. He's kind of like the secret agent of junglers here in Korea.
Makes sense.
He waits till you're alone and vulnerable, and then he strikes.
That's right. He has his pen filled with cyanide or something like that. He just like pokes you with it. He's like, oh, excuse me. Sorry, oh, is this your floor? I'll be getting off.
Oh, God, your British accent is terrible.
I didn't try it. That was not my full effort there. I'll work on it.
All right, Sivir Rek'Sai, no surprise from KT that these would be the selections. They get the same champions they had last game, and one would expect a very similar performance.
Yeah. Now, is Spenu brave enough to try the Echo? I wonder.
Well, they've been brave enough to try it before, but they already have a jungler, so that means they'd have to play it in one of their solo lanes, which is something we haven't seen from them yet.
Yeah, they did use it in the jungle yesterday, and it did not work out too well.
It certainly did not. Yeah. But very little that Spenu has done has worked out too well.
That's true, too. Yeah. All right, well, they can take the victor, I suppose. Edge did quite well on that.
So Nautilus and Victor will be the selections. Very meta composition coming in so far from Spenu. Not too much interesting from either of our teams yet. Will Edge go for the Cassiopeia pick? I love the Sivir Cassiopeia combo. Really does give you great chasing potential.
Yeah.
The ability to hunt down your opponents with a lot of that single target damage and gives you
yes.
even more speed than you generally see.
Every time I see Blitzcrank, I get excited for a second. Then I remember what happened to his W, and then I get sad.
Rip Blitzcrank.
Rip Blitz. Still be cool to see Fixer give him a try. In a situation like this, why not?
I mean,
you've got Sivir to compensate
exactly.
for the fact that your W is not, that's true.
Exactly. But I think the Thresh is definitely the safer choice here. And they will lock in the Azir as well. So Edge just playing some more poke-based champions today with the Victor and then the Azir. Playing it nice and safe. Has that ability to siege nicely as well with the Sivir. Good all-in capacity. I mean, pretty just standard meta compositions from both sides today. And notice that they saved Someday's pick for last. It is a good day to be a Someday.
I would agree. Well, Caitlyn would be an interesting choice because her changes are not in yet.
That
we
is very
true.
We
are not to that patch at this point.
Yeah, I think you just go with the Lucian and see if you can win lane right here. Try and punish Arrow as much as you can. We've seen Nuclear play that Tristana before, and it is a nice champion for fast pushing. And especially with Victor and Gragas, you have a lot of ways to poke people and get them off of turrets. Good zone control if you want to fast push with a Tristana might be pretty decent.
Ooh, would they actually try taking away the Riven here?
That would be bold. I mean, Sol has played Kedan, Sol has played Aurelia, so it's not like we haven't seen carry top lanes out of them, but is... No, Fizz.
Oh, no. It's Fizz. Fizz top lane has not been spectacular in champions lately.
It hasn't. It really has not worked in this league very well. We haven't seen really that dominating performance out of the Fizz top lane. We haven't mid lane. But the Cinder Hulk Fizz just, he has such little wave clear early on. Now, fortunately, yeah. that's going to be balanced out by the fact that Tristana and Victor are very capable of pushing turrets. So perhaps Sol can really make it work in that top side. But is Someday going to play this Riven for the second game in a row? Bit of an assassin dually matchup at the top side. It would be certainly be exciting.
Yeah. And we saw Shy try Fizz top on Wednesday. That was pretty bad.
Well, the composition was bad. I think that Fizz works, but it's just very situational, and you have to consider the compositions. Fizz and Gragas is good. You could break apart fights and get Fizz in those 1v1s where you can get extended autos off, but it will be, looks like, an Aurelia instead here against the Fizz in the top lane.
Interesting. And I mean, the thing is if you come in, you poke Aurelia with Fizz, you have to really be careful because if you get stunned, you can't playful trickster out of being stunned. So you're going to take some pretty decent trade damage from the Aurelia side.
That's right.
It's a good pick.
You come in and you get the damage over time, which basically guarantees you're going to have higher health. And unless, like during your Urchin Strike, if you just get stunned right on the opposite side of that, then you're going to eat a lot of Heaten style true damage. So it is interesting. We'll see how it actually plays out in the top side or not. Should be pretty fun matchup to watch. Skill-based matchup for sure.
Yeah. Well, Someday on that Aurelia should be right up his alley as far as some of those carry top laners can be. As far as this composition goes, though, you know, how does this Aurelia kind of fit in with the rest of what KT's got, just sort of as a split-pushing threat?
Split-pushing threat, absolutely. And they're going to have a very big power spike. But, I mean, if we just look at the way they could deal with the backline here of getting onto Victor with the Azir and the Aurelia, it's just a lot of skirmishing potential from KT's composition. Good 4-1. And Spenu, I don't really know how they're going to deal with this. Yes, they've got good reset potential for Tristana, but mostly I think they're going to have to hope for a fast push, get some of these outer turrets down very quickly, and hope that Sol gets big. But that is a long shot, in my opinion.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Spenu trying to tie things up. KT looking for the 2-0. Let's get in the game and see who takes it. Right, welcome to Summoner's Rift. KT Rolster taking on Spenu's Sonic Boom. And Seoul, after an incredibly trying game number one, is going to go ahead and take this Fizz to the top lane now. And KT, the cheese is strong with this one.
Yeah, they're going to wrap around into the try. And this is so dangerous. This is the Thresh Brush.
Oh, boy.
We've talked about this at Champions before.
Here comes. The hook misses, though. Secret going to the top of the brush.
Yeah, you have to be good heads-up play there by Secret to try and avoid that situation, because you have to be so careful against Thresh in that brush. They were ready for it. Didn't actually get hit by it, and that means that Spinnet will be able to back off in safety.
There's a pause, but KT was able to get a lot of deep wards done. So is this something you'd want to split push against, perhaps? I feel like standard lanes works fine for KT.
But for Spinnet, maybe you do want to just farm up that Tristana and then control the wave, not level and put any points in E and just sit there on all your skill points like we usually see Tristana players do.
Yeah.
Until you want to control it and start pushing out right now. You do have the Smite on Fizz as opposed to Aurelia. So there is some nice jungling that could possibly be done in a lane swap situation for Seoul. So I don't know. Mm-hmm. Kind of go either way on this one.
Yeah. Global fans. Nice. I like the hat with the dollar signs on it. That's pretty cool. Do you think I would look good in a hat like that, Monty?
Yes, every time.
I think so, too. That's right. I need to find out where he got that.
Also, I want you to go Flava Flav and get a big clock around your neck.
I could do that. Although, like, saying Doa Do doesn't, like, it doesn't sound quite as cool as Flava Flav, does it?
Doa Do.
Yeah, that does not work. I'll think of something better. I need a different rap name. That's really the key to it. That's right. Oh, we're back in the game. I'll have to think of my rap name some other time.
I mean, Dead on Arrival is already kind of a rap name.
It is. It's true, yeah.
Has some gangster flavor to it.
The Indomitable DOA. Put that in there.
It's a good one.
Yeah. Good work. Continuously mistaken for the game franchise, as it has been for 10 years or more now.
Beach Volleyball was my favorite version of you.
When is the sequel coming out, man? When is the sequel coming? Come on, we just E3. Where's the big announcement? Come on.
You know, you really missed when we were on the beach in Busan last year, the chance to get the DOA Beach Volleyball picture that we were
That's
all.
True.
Oh, we got. Oh,
did that, he
no,
nearly
he
got it.
It.
Nearly got it.
Cute.
It was close.
Cute moves from Fixer, who's back on Thresh, that champion that he really looked great on towards the end of last season and ended up getting a lot of bans. So always fun to see Fixer on Thresh.
Started with Q, which is not something we see all the time on Thresh. Usually it's been the Flay for a long time now, but trying to make use of the Q. I like it, you know? Trying to make something happen.
Yeah, it's smart adaptation. If you're going to be stuck with that Q early on, you might as well just go and try and make something out of it. And
yep.
Absolutely, Spinner did not expect that to happen.
Yeah, so I like this bot lane for Spinner. Got some good protection for Tristana, and of course they've got a champion that will be very strong late. Just in general, it seems like Spinner will be fairly strong late.
Yeah, I mean, they still kind of lack some tankiness. Oh. We'll see how this Fizz builds. Sasan going to chase Edge over the side alongside Catch, who comes in for an early 3-minute gank, but it's not going to work. Score getting very low at that red buff. We'll get some more HP with the help of his Smite before going down. And, you know, the problem, I think, with running Tristana into Sivir is that the explosive shot is really telegraphed as an ability, so it's pretty easy to spell shield that. You see it coming in. And it's kind of obvious, so I'm not sure that this is really going to be a very good matchup for Tristana. I'm not familiar with the reworked Tristana's matchups quite yet. That would be my hunch, is that it would be hard to get down damage, because where Tristana really thrives is in these extended traits where she could stack up that explosive shot.
Of course, yeah.
And when Arrow is able just to spell shield that, and then walk up and boomerang blade her, I just don't see that working out very well for the Trist.
Now, if Secret can get that spell shield used on a dredge line, then that does
that
open up some trades. So I think a lot of this depends on the coordination between Secret and Nuclear, and you know, if Secret can set something like that up. Because I think you're absolutely right. The trading from Tristana is pretty paramount, but it depends on Secret, you know?
Yeah, that's a very good point. Well, Someday's already up in this top side, and Fizz, of course, has that pretty weak early game, and Soul actually going for a Doran's Blade, so pretty aggressive opener here against Someday.
They're falling a bit behind in CS already, too.
Yeah, well, I mean, Fizz just, he's a very item-dependent champion. He can't do much without items. But usually we'd see the Cinder Hulk Fizz starting with a Flask, actually, in the top side, and not making that decision this time around. Ketch going to go ahead and get the Wolf Spirit out of Score's jungle, and he's not going to quite finish that. He knows he's there. They could collapse on him right now. Azir has an angle. They definitely could go for this, but Ketch is going to body slam away before Edge wants to leave lane.
Yeah, it doesn't look like they were too worried about stopping him. Just wanting to push that mid lane turret up, probably so Sossen can go back and buy, perhaps. Oh, Score comes in. There's a knockup on the Ketch. Ketch taking a lot of damage. Forced to flash. Can they finish him off? Oh, man, it was close. But they couldn't quite get him. They did get the flash, though.
And Sossen ghosted as well. So just a really awkward path there from Ketch. Actually forces two summoners out of Spenu. Nice aggression from KT, but that was a... Ketch just taking a little bit of a risk right there in terms of what he was trying to do, and Someday still going to be going ahead and winning these trades just using that E. Look how much damage is coming out the W. He's maxing E first.
Oh boy. Playful Trickster, though, bringing it right back for Soul. Hilarious. I know. You know, sometimes when you're watching a top lane 1v1, you just have to laugh so you don't cry. You know, usually that's more of a tank.
Yeah, this
one's
actually,
this one's better.
This is actually entertaining. I don't know what you're talking about, Doa.
I'm talking about the tank 1v1s. I just said that. Oh, Ketch discovers a wild Score.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy. In the top lane, Someday with the first blood. 1v1, man.
Score's risky pathing right there, though, around the back did force him to have to flash into the dragon pit. But Someday, so Soul hit level 6 first right there and tried to kind of style a little bit for that kill. But Someday got his Transcendent Blades and was able to turn it around. Let's take a look at what happened. Look at that 6 right there. Immediate all in from Someday. Soul gonna try and get that up, but flashback Q and then one auto. Well played by Someday. Kind of baiting Soul in. Soul not respecting the fact that Someday was about to hit level 6. Well played by Someday, though.
Yeah, no kidding. Now, the Skirmisher Saber is picked up by Soul now. I'm trying to remember if he had that before the fight.
No.
Okay.
They didn't have any items before the fight at all. Doran's Blade and some potions. So that was the first recall, the first back. But Someday gonna put together a... Sheen for himself. That burst damage going to be absolutely huge here.
Well, that's what you need. Again, you know, I feel like it's all about getting that stun with Equilibrium Strike and then front-loading the damage.
Yeah, Soul did go and get the Gromp buff, though, so that's going to make trading a little bit more difficult for Someday.
Certainly does help. You know, Edge with a bit of a CS lead. CS leads across the board, actually, for KT.
So they're going to see maybe if he'll use his Playful Trickster, but they should know he's here thanks to the Wolf Spirit. No, they're just going to go in, actually.
Yep, Soul getting stunned already. There we go, right into the knockup. Soul not taking a lot of damage yet. Score getting very low. Oh, man. Score! Well, gave one over to Soul there.
What an awkward tower dive from KT Rolster.
No,
I mean,
kidding.
They initiated that, and Someday was tanking the turret, but Soul was easily able to turn that around because there was just no damage coming in. They just sat there for a moment.
Yeah, the coordination was definitely not there. Ketch trying to steal the blue buff, but gets chased away by Fixer. Still trying, though. Here comes Sossen as well. KT might have a little bit of trouble with this one. Oh, but Edge trying to help. Looks like he's going to try to come over. Oh, got smited. Who did that go to? I think it went to Ketch, actually. Thinking to grab Secret. Actually, that's a lot of damage flayed in. Here comes Edge. Does KT want to try to pursue this?
They can TP
Cerulea. They can also do Dragon after pushing away. They're just going to activate the ult. They know that they can get a kill. They can kill off Secret, and they're going to push Spenu away, which could lead to an early Dragon as well.
Yeah, nice flash play from Fixer after the On the Hunt went down just to secure that kill. And they kind of mind-gamed a little bit. Secret, I think the rest of Spenu thought they may be able to get out of that situation, but instead We do see this.
Oh, challenging Smite used on Sunday right before he popped his ult that probably saved Soul right there. Oh, catch. Catch getting caught in his own jungle this time, though. There's the Flay from Fixer to keep him in place. He's going to body slam over the wall. Score going to chase. He's got to have that burrow up pretty soon. Using that Tremor Sense, misses the Prey Seeker, gets slowed by the barrel.
Here comes Zero.
Yeah, Nuclear right there as well, too. They're going to go over the wall. Oh, they grabbed him. Coming in, they're going to bring an Arrow as well with the Lantern. There's a kill on to catch Arrow, picking that one up there.
Great play from Fixer.
Yeah, very
good.
Gets
the Lantern into the Tri-Brush. Now, they thought that KT was going to be doing that Dragon, but they were Sunday in a 1v1. Another kill in the 1v1 for Sunday.
That healing from the ultimate is certainly making the difference.
Yeah, he didn't have it up during that fight. That's why Soul thought he could go in, was he had Fish.
Oh, you're right.
And Sunday had used the Transcendent Blades in an earlier little scrap. But at the same time, Soul, his only item was a Doran's Blade and a Skirmisher Saber. He didn't have that Cinder Hulk dud. So when you don't have, you invest so much.
Oh, Sossin coming up, looking for a very low health Sunday. Will he pick the right brush? He's got three to choose from. There's a ward. Checks the other one. Oh, he hits him right as he recalls, but he manages to make it out. That was like that game you see on the street where it's like find the acorn under the three cups, but it was like find the Aurelia in the three brushes. And he picked the wrong one. He picked the right one last.
The three brush Monty.
That's right. that works. That works.
Oh, man. Well, Sunday does escape.
Yep.
At the end right there. Sossin also blew his ult to get that. So Edge going to look for the kill right now. Sossin, no mana, no ultimate, has to flash.
Yeah, flash from Sossin. He's going to lay down that gravity field. It does catch score for now, but catch is going to take a lot of damage as well here. They don't need to really stop pressuring. Someday's nearby. He's going to come down for the moment, but looks like they're going to let that go for now. Still no dragon for either team either.
No, if you're KT right now, you really want to get some more deep wards in now that you know the mid is backing, as well as trying to get some damage down onto turret in the mid lane if you can. I'm surprised that Score is just going to recall right here instead of using that timing just a little bit better. But he's got Void Rush. He'll be back on the map in just a moment. And that is a nice freeze that Sunday has going on right now. He's got the Phage as well. So back to that duel. Soul didn't have Smite in the top lane. It was down. It was on cooldown. And his only item besides a Doran's Blade was the Skirmisher's Saber. So under those circumstances, you really can't duel because you've invested to make your Smite do something.
Yeah.
And that's the only thing that you have in terms of combat. Whereas this Aurelia has a Sheen. So even if you have that ult, it's really scary.
Well, Soul played it really, or Sunday rather, played it really well too. He went in, forced the trade early on that got that Smite used. Then after it was done, came in again.
Yeah. Well, Sunday, very comfortable on this Aurelia, as we can see, in spite of that kill on the horrible turret dive.
Well, another duel up in top lane. Sunday taking the ult from Fizz. Looks like it's not going to do a whole lot, though.
Yeah, still has Transcendent Blades as well. He'll be able to heal up off the max minion wave if he so chooses. Or he can take a little trip back home.
Yep, this turret shouldn't take any damage.
Score is soloing Dragon right now.
Why not? Fixer and Arrow can come up and help. And Edge there as well, too. So finally that first dragon taken.
So Sunday's recall was just to cover his teammates. He had gotten low after that skirmish. He still had his ultimate. He knew Fizz's ult was down, and he had the wave pushed up because all he did was go back and buy a dragon. The reason why he did that was because if in a TP situation, if they came to intercept the dragon, he would be able to TP in with an ult and full HP and therefore almost certainly win that team fight. So that's just really good coordination around KT to make sure that that dragon was done very safely.
Yeah, it worked out well. So despite that kind of minor misstep with the gank in top lane, the turret dive, everything else moving pretty smoothly for KT again here in game two. Already up to a 2K gold lead, 3-4. They've got the dragon. Turrets are going to start falling within the near future, you'd have to imagine.
Yeah, Sunday again doing very well on the top side in spite of things being a little bit more even. Score going to get found right there.
Yeah, catch. I wonder if he knew he was there. Gets knocked up on, though. Edge coming over the wall. They have the support there as well, too. Pushes Sossin back in. Box dropped by Fixer. There goes Sossin. A kill for Edge. Really nice play using the Emperor's Divide to push Sossin back into Fixer's box.
Man, Sossin just didn't expect that either. Not a lot of mana. Sunday going to take a turret hit right now. Soul trying to go in.
Yeah, Sunday, does he have quite enough? Oh, can't quite dodge the playful Trickster. That top lane has been such a duel fest. It's gone both ways. We've got like two solo kills for each of them at this point.
Yeah, Someday right there took a tower hit, and Soul was able to turn that into a kill now that he has that Cinder Hulk. So
not bad.
Nice little reversal. Someday still a little bit short of that finish onto the Trinity Force, but in the meantime, Arrow's going to get a lot of damage onto the bottom tower.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the CS for Someday as well, too, he's 20 up.
Oh, he's
still
fine.
Looking fine, yeah. Still winning the lane. One death as opposed to the two for Soul. So looking pretty good.
There we go. Tower finished. First one of the game just before 15 minutes here as KT racks up some global gold. And they're just going to back off. So no real conversion right here. Sassen. Clean out that minion wave as Edge goes to pick up the blue buff. Trinity Force now done for Someday. Did wait just a little bit, and Soul will be going for the Cinder Hulk into Trinity Force build. So he's going to be doing damage, but he's well behind at the moment.
Seems like a pretty strong power spike for KT right now with the Infinity Edge done, the Morell and Namakon now on the Edge. Basically, everybody getting their first core item, and here comes Secret up to the top lane.
Yeah, they really want to shut down this Aurelia, but everyone from KT making their way up at the top as well, right as Someday gets there. And the thing is, Bennu doesn't have any deep wards besides this one in the Tribe Rush, so they're not going to be so confident in their abilities. Score going to come in. Oh, he's going to get seen by a pink ward, but Someday's already in.
There we go. They knock Someday back with the explosive cast getting very, very low. Fixer coming in to try to save his top laner. He does. Flash knock up from Score. That's a kill from Edge. And KT turning that one around very nicely.
Yeah, they did. Still dangerous. KT showing a bit of a lack of coordination right there just because they didn't know whether there was a ward in the brush in the river, and Someday had already gone in. They're going to keep on piling through there. They're in the jungle. Oh. Fixer here.
Yeah, Sassen taking a little bit of damage. Soul right there. They have to pull out Edge, though. Got a bit low.
Yeah, but they got the ult, and Arrow is sitting in a brush right now. Big play. Here's a teleport.
Yep, that's right. Wow, Edge already very low health. Catch, oh, he tries a body slam over the wall. Can't get through with it. Someday over the wall himself after Soul. Here comes Edge. Here comes Score now. Knockups into the box. Sassen goes down. Edge very low, but staying on the edge of the fight, and he should just be perfectly fine. They'll be able to grab this blue buff on the way out, too.
Edge is playing around his low HP so well this game. He's actually surprising the enemy. Surprise Sassen in the mid lane with that all in. And looks like Spenu really wants to take the blue buff, but they're not going to be able to get through the meat wall in front of it, and Edge will take it away.
A good knockup onto Soul as he came in to try to smite that. Not giving him the opportunity. So now the game blown wide open, 6,000 gold ahead for KT. They've gotten two turrets, only need to work on that top one, and Someday may have it down very, very soon. So it's like we said, you know, a few minutes ago, the power spike has happened. KT is going to start taking turrets. They're going to start winning fights. Is there anything Spenu can do right now?
No, probably not. Okay. I mean, Arrow has done such a good job this game of just taking towers. He took mid while the rest of his team has been controlling Spenu and forcing these very favorable fights. Arrow's just been wave clearing with his boomerang, standing in the lane, autoing the turrets, and that's led to this two tower lead right now.
Oh, Soul. Uh-oh. In trouble. And uses his ult. Goes on to Someday. Someday taking some turret hits, getting very low. Soul, wow. Someday nearly getting taken out. Soul doing everything he can, but just a bit too late at this point. Meanwhile, Arrow jumped on by Catch and Secret in the bottom. There's the ultimate. Nuclear there as well to help out, so they will be able to get the pick onto Arrow in bot lane.
But how much else are they going to be able to get right here? They do have a minion wave relatively close, and remember, Nuclear is on this Tristana. That Tristana does a lot of damage to turrets. Look at the chunk that's going to be taken out right there.
They're going to get it.
Huge amounts of damage. You cannot leave Tristana in lane alone with your tower right now. They get the tower in the top side in recompense, so it's still a two-tower lead for KT, and now they're going to set up around the dragon.
Yeah, and the most important thing, not just being two towers ahead, but having all of that map control that comes with having the outer line of turrets out of the way.
So Someday has QSS as his second item, so giving him that MR and the ability to drop the fish. And that's really the key thing right here, is he thinks he's going to be scrapping more and more with Soul, because that's the only reason you would get a QSS.
Yeah, it kind of makes it look like he wants to keep split pushing, right?
Yep, and he's He's destined and determined to win these duels. There's TP. Some days is down, but he is on the flank already.
Well, Dragon's still going to KT. Catch came in to try to help him. Wow, nice grab from Dixer. Sick death sentence, and there goes the jungler. They were so ready for Catch to come in. Sivir Ultimate activated. Can KT catch up? Going to the Raptors is Someday. Can he catch anyone else? He's going to go for Spirit. Gets a slow with that Equilibrium Strike. Spirit getting or yeah, Secret getting very low. Now he's dead. Sossin in a little bit of trouble. Edge doing a lot of damage. Someday push back against the wall. Sossin barely makes it up due to the Summoner heal from Nuclear. So it looks like that's all KT is going to be able to get kill-wise in this fight.
Really nice follow-up there from Someday. I think what was really cool about what we saw from the Aurelia was that I believe what happened is that he queued onto a small Raptor, killed it with the Sheen proc to reset. I didn't even know you could do that with Aurelia. I didn't know those little Raptors had such a small amount of HP. But that's a really cool trick for Aurelia players if you're chasing through the jungle. Just queue onto a small Raptor with that Trinity Force. You'll be able to take it out immediately and then follow up on the chase. That was neat.
Worked well. Now, Someday is 3-1-3, Soul is 2-3-1. The top lane is very much in KT's favor now. 7,000 gold lead already. And here is where it all starts to fall apart for Spenu, or where it continues to fall apart for Spenu.
Look how many wards KT got into the bottom side of the jungle while they were running through on that chase. Just absolutely 100% vision. But they're not doing a very good job of defending their turrets right now. Nuclear. And the rest of Spenu find another one, and you just need a couple of seconds with that Tristana. Arrow trying to push into the bottom side, but he doesn't have very much mana to sustain this, so KT not putting up the best defense possible.
Yeah, I sense a little bit of cockiness, a little bit of laziness from KT right now.
Especially with the Dragon dead, there's no reason to commit a lot of resources to the bottom side when you could be saving your turrets instead.
Yeah. Arrow just really wanting to push down this bottom lane turret. Fixer's there to support him if Sossin is there, and he is. Sometimes I feel like teams try to close and push turrets too aggressively, you know? And then they end up making the game take even longer, even though the purpose is to make it take less time.
Well, KT usually can close out, though. I mean, they're a team that isn't afraid to dive. They will just keep on hammering at the gates until they break through. Now, you know, cautious they want to be this time around. They could set up for a big dive right here. There's really no ramifications. As long as they have pressure advantage, you can just keep diving, and no one's really going to be able to punish you for it while the death timers are still so low.
Works out. Score is like, yeah, I believe I will take your Raptor camp. Oh, yep, he still got it. Thought maybe Soul could smite it away. But Score was able to grab it.
Now, Someday not so far ahead of Soul this game as he was last time. Still pretty far up in terms of CS, but that level advantage that he had, the three-level advantage, was really the more overwhelming part of it. And now that is not going to be a feat that is repeated. Fixer gets
caught.
Whoa,
nice ultimate from Catch. Looks like they're going to get a kill on the Thresh here. Score comes in as well. Here comes Arrow with a lot of damage. Oh, man. Catch just getting evaporated. Edge coming in with Someday as well. Goodbye, Nuclear. Double kill for Someday already. Another one for Edge comes in as well. Sossin and Soul doing whatever they can. Edge gets hit with the Fizz ultimate. Soul manages to pick one up, but Arrow's going to finish him off. Someday actually gets that one instead. So KT still trading 2-for-4. Yeah. Not the cleanest fight ever, but it worked out.
But Someday with a big, big cleanup right there, actually taking 3 kills over the course of that fight. You can see this is Aurelia's power spike right now. She's not going to get really stronger than she is at the moment. There you go. Sossin gets dove, and Someday gets another one underneath the tower.
Well, when you say that KT is not afraid to dive in the late game to finish off the game quicker, you meant it.
Yeah, they're a team that really likes to snowball gold leads off of kills. And they are very good at playing Sivir to catch you off guard and to go full tilt into the enemy composition.
Makes sense. 10,000 gold lead now. Let's watch that fight again. It started out okay.
Fixer was just clearing a ward right there. Does get caught and blown up by Catch. But Arrow here following up immediately. And Someday on the flank. Look at this. Gets a kill. Then he's going to use his Transcendent Blades.
Wow.
The last one finishes off. Secret gets taken out by Edge right there. And Soul sees an opportunity. He sees Edge with the fish on him. Landed that. So he's going to go ahead and take out Azir. But Someday just there constantly auto-attacking him. And then finishes him off with the Q.
So Spenu scrambling to do anything they can, but they're down 4 turrets to 2 now.
And look at Sunday, just building so much MR at this point. He's decided that nuclear really isn't a threat to him. He's going to get the CDR. He's going to get more MR so that he can keep split pushing against Sol or 1v1 Sossin as well at any time he wants. Yeah, Sol's getting some attack damage with that Sheen, but he's not quite finished with that Trinity Force yet.
Yeah, it looks like he's got a ways. I mean, he just went back and he only picked up a dagger, so he is... got a ways to go before he finishes that Trinity Force.
Yeah, probably about 800 gold. Not sure exactly where he ended up on the spectrum right there, but certainly he's not in a situation where he's going to be comfortable dueling against a 7-1-4 Aurelia.
Yeah, I don't think so. Dragon up in about 10 seconds now. KT going back to group for that. Sol duking it out with Sunday a little bit. Secret's right there. Pops at you for the slow. Catch
There's
comes in, mixing it up with score. Yep, QSS use edge over the wall, right on the catch, bending the soldier to get into it. Sossin getting chased down by score. Meanwhile, Sol gets into the back lines, immediately regrets it. Oh, death sentence! How in the world did he hit? Sol drops the box immediately. Double kill for Edge. Secret trapped in the back lines again. A triple kill now for Edge. And only Sossin and Nuclear remaining. This could be an inhibitor.
Yeah, they're just going to push on through right now. They have a Trinity Force. They have a Sivir who's just going to auto-reset on the turret. And that's going to be it.
That was
the
easy.
The inhibitor will die, even though these death timers are still quite short.
And they can take Dragon number 3 on the way out, too.
They definitely can. Just head right over to the objective, pick it up, and keep on rolling here. Take the red buff for Arrow. Just give him a little bit of a refresh.
Why not? It's that. It's a little bit of health back. Now it's dragon time. Getting that movement speed from that third dragon.
This is a good call from Spenu.
Yeah, trying to sneak a Baron while KT is occupied.
This is about all they can do. So
might
the fact
well
that there
it.
Are no wards right now, everyone's just recalling. This is going to be a Baron for Spenu.
Yeah, they're actually taking it quite fast, and KT going to be a bit annoyed by this.
Well, Sunday's going to check it.
He's going to find it, but it's going to be a little bit too late, I think.
Is it?
Or is it? Well, yeah, there goes Baron. And Sunday does have to kind of let that one go. So
that was
good call by Spenu.
That was a great call from Spenu. KT, sloppy with their warding, didn't have vision on that objective, and so they lose it. But Spenu, the instant reaction after losing that inhibitor and thinking that they were going to that KT would just go to Dragon this early on. No one thinks that Spenu would actually go for a Baron at 26 minutes with the kind of deficit that they already have, and that buys them at the very least a little time.
Yeah, well, it's going to be easier to at least push back that super minion wave and bot with your Baron-powered minions anyway.
Yeah, I'm very impressed. That was, yes, it was KT's mistake for allowing that to happen. They absolutely did not have to all simultaneously recall right there. They could have sent somebody over to pop down a trinket ward or what have you. So a bit sloppy play from KT, but I mean, Spenu took the gamble and it paid off.
Worked out. That's what you got to do. That's the kind of life that we've been looking to see from Spenu all season long.
Yeah, definitely. I think that was a great shot call.
Yep. About time. Now, can they make more than one a series? That's the real trick right there.
Well, don't ask for too much, Tom.
I'm going to get my expectations. Sol, taking a bit of damage, gets back to the safety of the turret. KT trying to put as much pressure as they can on this top lane, even with that Baron for Spenu. Meanwhile, the bottom lane pushing up. Arrow takes the mid lane tier 2. Wow, really?
Arrow is basically just like a banner of command this game.
Pretty much.
All right, so here we go. They had to send Nuclear back to clear out these super minions. That means that this Spenu team is actually highly diveable right now, even though it's taking a long time to chew through these Baron minions.
A lot of poke coming in from that Azir, too. They need to be careful about it. Tier 2 getting extremely low, but the minion wave goes down, so it looks like they'll have to wait for the next one. The super minions still pushing up in that bottom lane.
Yeah, they could just wait this out right here.
Yeah.
KT, keep this siege on even with the Baron buff. They have such a massive gold lead.
Well, I mean, it's really looking like this Baron buff's not really going to benefit Spenu really at all. Oh, here we go. Silver ult activated. They're going to go in on this one as the tower goes down. Knock up on the catch. And Secret throws the ult on a Fixer for some reason. Might be a misclick there. Arrow with the first kill. Emperor's Divide used to just sort of separate the members of Spenu. Two easy kills for KT, and they are ready to push through for another inhibitor, potentially in top lane.
Yeah, they have to wait for this minion wave, though. That may give them enough time to home guard right here. They're going to try and hide a little bit. They've already swept out that area.
Might work.
So they're going to see if they get a lucky hook. No one's going to walk up, so they come with the wave to deal with the turret. Good damage from the death ray, but it's just not going to be enough.
Yep. They will take out that turret. Now going in again. Someday takes some damage. Nuclear trying to do it again. Nice knockup from Score. Nuclear really taking out. Whoa! Someday manages to catch him with the Blade Surge. Backing off. And they're going to grab the inhibitor on the way out, it looks like. Sasa's got a chance for a kill or two here. Someday going back in. He's crazy. Whoa! Yep, Sasa got that one. There we go, though. One last auto, and it looks like Arrow will be able to take the inhibitor. So mission accomplished, quote-unquote.
Well,
they got the inhibitor, but they lost Someday.
He was very low, and Victor did come back for the lantern for Arrow just so they could get out of that situation and take the inhibitor well. You know, Someday was very close to getting the kill on a catch right there and trading one for one, but
why not?
Ultimately on that press, it did. I mean, we're only 30 minutes into this game. Someday is going to be back in 18 seconds, and honestly, securing the inhibitor is definitely worth losing a player for at this point in time, as you're trying just to put as much pressure on as you can to close the game. So not that much of a ramification. Baron's already down, Dragon's down, so I think that's a good trade.
Should be fine. Speaking of Dragon, it will be live again in about a minute 30. KT with a chance to claim their fourth there. Someday, meanwhile, just doing a bit of counter jungling. And I believe the inhibitor, the inhibitor and bot is back now. So we'll see what KT decides to prioritize here over the next few minutes.
Well, they have Dragon number 4 in their sights, for sure. Whether they want to wait for that objective or try pushing a lane first is going to be the real question here. So there's a big slow push developing in the top side, so that should be done and at the base by about the time they finish the Dragon and set up again.
Yep.
A lot of options for KT in terms of their side wave pressure and the timings. Looks like they just want to go for the inhibitor, and they're going to pink ward their flanks right now. Now, Fizz is coming in from behind.
He's going to try. Catch doesn't hit the body slam. Someday backing out for just a moment. They pop the Sivrel for a bit more mobility. There's a zoning box to keep Sol from coming in too easily. Gets onto Arrow anyway. Use that playful tricks a bit. Look at this. Edge already with the double kill. Someday picks one up as well. There goes Sossin. Sol the only one left alive, and he has to run away. Wasn't able to get anything done. There goes the inhibitor. And that may very well be the game right there. We'll see if they're willing to tank the turret. I suppose they do have minions up in top lane here. Nope, just going to tank it. They're going to take out those turrets so fast.
Yeah, they are. And they also just have so much HP right now. It's not really an issue. But man, the team fighting was so good from KT. Fixer had the vision. Fixer zoned out Sol instantly. And as soon as the fish came in, as we see Sol die here in the end of things, as soon as the fish came in, we saw Edge go into the fight, open up room with an Emperor's Divide. That was really good Azir team fighting from Edge right there, actually.
Edge had a great game, man. 9-3 and 10 on Azir. You look at some days 9-2 and 12. You know, Edge not doing too bad compared to the other members of his team for a guy we haven't seen for a very long time. It's looking good.
And Fixer's Thresh continues to be a threat. I think that was a great game from Fixer as well.
Yeah.
So tough loss for Spenu, but they held up better certainly than they did in that first game. But they continue to kind of go through this season, trudge through with just a single win.
And not trying to take the Sivir away from KT. We talked about it going into today. Sivir is such a strong pick for this team right now. And we saw Arrow just be able to support so well with that champion. But Spenu not wanting to touch it, I guess.
Yeah, I think it's still a big weakness for